relaxation in a second, but yeah, glad you're all here. Sorry to start a little bit. But yeah, let's go ahead and just do a brief relaxation separate. Breathe in deeply. Breathe out slowly, just releasing the breath without forcing it, like the air coming out of the balloon. Relax the neck. Feel the shoulders relax. Relax around the low back and the waist. Relax down the legs. Relax the tops of the feet. Next exhale, release, lower the hands, open the eyes. Separate the feet to a shoulder width apart. Continue with a little, just 2 minutes or so of our bracing force. Bend the knees, circle the arms, back. Sit back, let the upper body move forward. Feel the pelvis tuck under. Straighten the legs over the hands. Circle the arms up, breathe in. Push palms down, breathe out. Good. Okay. All right, so it's the last class of the unit. And as fate would have it, the last class in this room. So next week we'll be starting up at the new location. So if you have, I don't know if you all have questions about that or if we'll go to speak.
Kick-off.
You got it. Yep, right next door down the airport, right before you hit I guess they call it Canyon Fair, 2222. All right. And okay. So any other questions before we begin? Okay. So testing, I would be testing anyone who was testing, but no one in here is testing. So we'll review the whole thing first. So that whole first section, and then nice and slow, just work on moving smoothly, breathing, relaxing.
shoulder. Wide crane, spread wings. Brush knee, push one. Playing guitar, one. Brush knee, push two. Brush knee, push three. Brush knee, push four. Playing guitar, two. Brush knee, push five. Hidden hand punch. Withdraw and push. Cross hands.
Do you know that sometimes in China, if you would learn Tai Chi, all you would do is you would just show up and just follow along the whole thing. There wouldn't be any questions or any details or anything like that. I think eventually you could get it, but I think I like the analytical approach too. So let's go. Let's do this. Does anyone have a question about one of those moves? Any of them, because this would be your class to review and cover and fill in any gaps that you feel like you have so far. Yes, ma'am.
So on play guitar, are you still kind of like sunk down as your arms go out, or do you straighten up?
Good question.
I don't know if that makes sense.
Yeah, it does. Let me demonstrate it with that in mind, and then I'll try to answer it for you. So let's see. So I come from brushing push. And here I do have a sunk down kind of feeling. Like, this leg's pretty straight, not locked out, but pretty straight. But the front leg feels like half of that embracing horse thing we started with. So I definitely feel sunk down into that front leg. Right? And then when I follow through, I want to watch how to not come up there, which maybe that's what you're asking. Maybe you're asking about the part after, let's see. So when I follow through, I might actually come down a little bit. And then I shift back, and yeah, I don't want to come up. To shift back and open the arms.
Okay.
And then I just put that heel down, shift that 10% of my weight into it, and close the arms.
Okay, because I think I'm straightening up.
Straightening up in the body. Yeah.
Yeah.
The feeling in playing guitar is one way to look at it. The feeling is kind of opening side to side and then closing it. Yeah. And when we learn the application, it's actually coming together as an attack on someone's elbow and wrist. So it's kind of an attack on an arm and a feel. That there's definitely like out to the sides, back together. Good question. Does that answer it? Let's do the playing guitar just a few times together, just so we can narrow in on that, and then maybe we'll take a look at another move after that. Let's start from brush knee push. It could be one, it could be four, because there's a guitar after each, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, get into your good brush knee push position. I'll review with the instruction too a little bit, just to lock it into the brain. Follow through and step up halfway with the toe and turn the heel in a little bit. Shift back, open the arms. Close the arms, set the left heel. And at
the end, look for that feeling of 90% of the weight in the back leg and 10% in the front. Also, the image of the front leg as being your kickstand to keep you from coming forward. Hold there. Okay, kind of memorize what it feels like and then release it. Let's do it a couple more times without all the instruction and correction, just to feel through it. And just to put that in context, just to help us memorize the whole form, we have those first few moves where we go pull back, press, push, single lift. We have the lift and stretch shoulder bike crane, and then we have our brushing push section, which has two tars in it. Here and here. So just to put it in context, sometimes it helps to see it at a slightly different speed. That's very fast. Oh, cool. All right, is there another move that anyone
question, but it's not really about a move per
That's
se.
Right. What's your question?
The breathing. Is there like a set breathing in each of these? I don't know if I'm opening up a can of worms there
you
with
are.
That, but
it's a good can though, so
that's actually the question I was gonna ask, the breathing during all these moves. Because I don't feel like I am doing it when of course I don't expect to do it now, but
yeah.
Is there a certain in and out as you're
there is, yeah. So I'll give you like the very, very, very beginner answer, which is to make sure you're not holding your breath. So just slow breath, deep breath, don't hold your breath. Right? That's like, without any memorization, that's something you can do correctly right away. Then there's actually memorizing the breath that goes with each part of the motion. And I can give you the general rule, I'll demonstrate it. So start off here, and then we'll do this together. That'll be something fun to work on. Yeah. So, So I'll lead us through it, which is actually what we're doing in black size training in this unit, which is interesting. So I'll lead us through it, and then we'll talk about how to generalize it. Okay. Nice and a little slow. But breathe in before you begin. And then breathe out as you sink instead. Keep breathing out as you sink. Hold a moment, breathe out, as they go. Try to let your exhale be pretty complete. Breathe in as you're turning and filling out the board off position. Breathe out as you're shifting, releasing your footing to step in and step out. Breathe in as you shift into the posture. Breathe out as you release and step in and step out. Breathe in as you press, filling out the posture. Breathe out as you continue back, pull back. And then breathe in to press. Breathe out, follow through, shift back. Then breathe in to push. So let's do a sample of the first few moves. So release. Now, let's do that one more time together. Because that was the first time you've ever done it, obviously. And then we'll talk about it. Did that seem slow? Or did it seem okay?
It's not.
breath, it starts begging the board to be more continuous. So breathe in. Exhale. So, questions, comments, suggestions? What does that seem like?
It's easier to follow than chin. But
yes.
I know
Yeah.
It seems to go on a pattern.
Mm-hmm.
It's not all of a sudden, hold your breath.
Yeah.
So once you get in that groove, okay.
Yeah.
Inhale, exhale.
Yeah.
It does seem to help the moves a little bit. Just...
Yeah, it makes some... I find that in my practice, once I remember to breathe, it becomes instantly more connected and fluid and less jerky or something. I don't know, like the movement and breath just go together.
Yeah, and that's how I felt. I guess it was awesome that she asked the same thing, because I was trying to practice the other day, and I was like, man, it's just not, I don't feel like I'm getting it.
Yeah.
Because I'm supposed to be breathing, but I don't know how to do it.
Yeah.
But it really did feel really wonky, so.
Well, yeah. Until, you know, maybe that gives you a sense of so we'll talk a little general, sort of like how to tell when to breathe in, breathe out, and why. So I think of breathing out as sort of deflating the body, right, and sinking and getting out to the next place, right? And then I feel like breathing in, I think it was like filling the body, which it is in a way, and also filling out the posture to its full fullness. And then exhaling, and I feel the release and sink and step. Usually the stepping happens during the exhale. And then the move itself happens during the movement. And if you want a real world analogy for this, for something like push, so imagine that you were having to help a friend like push their car and it died or something. What would you do? You would, right? You would fill in, like we subconsciously breathe in to support the diaphragm, the structure of our body. You wouldn't go, well, you can't go on and do it. You wouldn't breathe out. Answer your question?
Yes,
okay, cool. And then once you have the moves all memorized, it's easier to sort of get the breath into them. It's a lot to memorize all at once. Yeah,
I figured it was more of a question for later, but I was like, it was bugging me.
Yeah, no, I'm glad you asked. That's like we always say it, like, if you have a question, ask it, because probably someone else in the room has the same question. We have proof right here.
I found it more relaxing. I feel like that was the first time I've done that section of the form, and it's actually felt relaxing.
Yeah, actually.
Congratulations.
I felt like I was more moving than with my body.
You were thinking about your breath, and your body was doing it.
Yeah.
I wasn't thinking so much about my feet and where I was.
Yeah. And isn't that one of the great things about breath? It's just a nice shortcut to get out of your head, because you're instantly in your, mentally at least, in your body. The connection between autonomous, sympathetic, whatever they call it. Okay, shall we? Let's do the whole thing one more time.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I don't know if we get to work on another move in particular, or just do some general form practice. Let's just run the whole thing a couple of times. If a question comes up during this run, I'll be open to asking it, but otherwise, we'll just practice again. Just for fun, I'll say the breath. Do you want to try to do it? Exhale. Inhale. Try not to go too slow. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. exhale. Three question pushes in the room. Was that? Yeah, found a lot. And as I was in the middle of it, I realized, oh, also some of these postures, the learning version doesn't quite work with the breath. I don't know if you noticed that. So I put an extra breath into hidden hand punch because the learning version is so broken down from what the move will eventually be that it only takes one breath. Like when smoothed out, this move will appear a little bit more like this. So. Took more time than I thought it would. Any last questions, comments, suggestions?
Just I have one that, as far as the moving of the body, as you're doing the moves, do you want to, because I feel like I'm just sort of drifting, I'm moving too much that way. Should you be more stationary with the movements?
Advancing is correct. The way Tai Chi works, people with different sized limbs will tend to advance farther more quickly, just like walking, I guess, For the same amount of move, like a person with longer limbs will advance more. So we'll have a thing in class where if you're behind someone shorter than you, you'll find yourself gaining on them, or if you're behind someone who's taller than you, they'll find themselves, they're taking off from you, leaving you behind. Let's see if I can have a better answer. I'll just say this. It might take a little while, a little practice just to get the sense of how far they move, but I haven't seen anything that I would like correct for being too stationary or too movement. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Okay, I just wanted to make sure.
Yeah, like a lot of these moves do advance a little bit or a lot. So. Okay, cool. Any others? So this has been a fun testing, non-testing day. Get to kind of play around and finish the unit off. And I'm not sure yet if we will start over at the beginning of the form again, or if we'll switch over to NACOM, the 10 foundational postures. Either one, I think, would be great for this group. So I'll try to figure that out before next month. Let's now have the 5 hearts. We follow the 5 hearts: faith, respect, perseverance, patience, and humility.
Bow to senior head instructor.
And bow to beginner students. Training is dismissed.